Hey everybody, Spencer here. Hope you're having a great week so far. I'm feeling a little under the weather today. I spent the weekend helping a friend move to New Hampshire. So first I had to drive a giant truck to New Hampshire, and that was a real pain in the butt. It actually broke down halfway there, so we were stuck at a truck stop for 5 hours waiting for it to get fixed. And then I spent the rest of the weekend unpacking the truck, helping unpack the boxes, trying to get stuff in order, and then I flew back yesterday. So, sorry I missed yesterday, but I was on a plane. Anyway, today I am playing Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic. It was actually requested last week by a viewer by the name of So Far So Good So What 14, and thought I would go ahead and play it. I thought it was a great idea. When this game came out first on the Xbox, the original Xbox, and I didn't actually have that system. But I didn't want to miss this game. I was so hyped for it. So this is actually one of the first games that I bought, if not the very first game, that I bought for a system I didn't own. And I went over to a friend's dorm room at University of Alabama in Huntsville, and I said, I'm going to play this game, and he said, okay. I then proceeded to camp out on his couch for like a week, and I didn't move. I didn't leave, I just played the game, and I really enjoyed it. Now, I guess there were a couple reasons why I didn't move. First, I was really enjoying the game, and I was really into it, and wanted to finish it. But second, I was at somebody's house. I was at somebody else's place, and I wanted to get it over with, So that I was no longer inconveniencing him. Not that it really bothered him that much, just, you know, I wanted to get out of his hair. I really did enjoy this game a lot. Not only because it was, you know, a very well-done RPG, but because it was the first Star Wars game in a while that took any chances with the formula. It didn't focus specifically on the events of the film, and it tried to do its own thing, and that's something that's missing from a lot of Star Wars games. I like the movies, but I often feel like the games are sort of shackled to the movies in such a way that they aren't allowed to thrive on their own merits. And this is a game that was definitely allowed space to breathe and to kind of make its own mark. And that's one of the reasons I think people enjoyed it so much. Beyond it being a good game, it was a new Star Wars experience, which is something I think a lot of people want. I hope that in the future there's more of this. And you know, we're about to get The Old Republic, which I'm going to play it, and I'm looking forward to it on a certain level. But on another, I'm very concerned. BioWare is doing it, and that's all well and good, but it's also some of the team from the Warhammer Online game are doing it, and I don't know. I felt like that game was a huge disappointment, so I'm reluctant to get too excited about The Old Republic at this point. But this is one of the games. Knights of the Old Republic is one of the games that I do go back occasionally and play. I don't think the PC port is particularly good, but it's still fun to play. I never did play all the way through Knights of the Old Republic 2. That's something I'd like to do eventually, someday, maybe, but I haven't done it so far. So, have you played Knights of the Old Republic? What do you think? Do you like it? Is it fun? Is it crap? What should I be playing instead of this? Let me know. I will see you guys tomorrow.